Hi, I'm Kate Kendall.
And I'm Melissa Bell. Thanks for sending your questions in to Facebook and Twitter.
And we're going to try and answer as many as we can.
This is from Tom. Hi, Tom. How hard is it playing a role that's already been set up by someone else?
It is quite difficult in some ways, but in other ways, I've just tried to create a little bit of a new character in the new Lauren Turner. Obviously, we have a history of the character as you would have come into contact with her years ago. But for our purposes, we thought it's been such a long time, let's just not try to redo somebody else's interpretation of the character. You know?
Do you feel like any pressure in a certain way? Like, do you feel the pressure's on you to...
The only pressure I feel is that, you know, you just want people to have a good response to the character. Embrace the character and not like that you feel like you've betrayed the fans who've watched the show for a long time. You want them to kind of go, okay, well, that was Lauren, now this is the new Lauren. Mm. But you don't want people to go, oh, no, that's not the Lauren we want to see, yeah. You know. So hopefully they like the new version. You weren't the first Lucy either, were you?
No, I was actually the third.
No way!
yes, but for me, playing Lucy was played by a couple of other actresses when she was quite young.
Oh.
So I came back as the sort of 17, 18-year-old, so the grown-up Lucy, if you'd like. She'd been away at boarding school, then she'd come back to Erinsborough to live back at home. Mm. Yeah, but it was great because there was a gap. I suppose. Yes. So Lucy had grown up and changed a lot, so yes. I could, you know, make her a lot sort of different. Yeah.
Okay, this one's from Nicole, and she's asking, what's it like coming back on Neighbours and meeting new people?
Oh, gosh, I love coming back to Neighbours. Done it quite a few times now, but no, it's great. And, you know, this is the first time I've worked with you, Kate, which has been really good.
Yeah.
Meeting different, there's new faces. But it's still, there's a real sort of family community here, and it's always been like that. Even 20 years ago when I first came onto the show, it's still...
20 years, wow.
Yeah, it's a long time. Okay, this is from Nina.
Mm-hmm.
Will Lauren ever make a play for Brad, as she clearly still has feelings for him?
I suppose she does have feelings for him in the sense that Brad was her first love. And so I don't think that ever really goes away. And also given the fact that he left her, you know, so he left her for Beth and married Beth, so that there's still this sort of sense of maybe something a little bit unresolved in Lauren, like the one that got away or the first something. Love that, you know, she never really got to get over. So maybe their feelings get a little bit confused there. I mean, she's still very much in love with her husband. Will she make a play for Brad? I really don't know. You'd have to ask the writers. Mm. But I know that they'll keep popping up in each other's lives because they've spent so much time together over the years.
They've got a history.
They've got a history, yeah. So I think there might be some interesting stuff on the horizon with those two characters. But I wouldn't go so far as to say she's going to make a play just yet. But you never know.
You never know.
You never know in this show. Okay, this is from Jessica. Jessica asks, now, what is your favourite storyline of all time?
Gosh. There's so many things have happened to Lucy. favourite storyline. Oh, my gosh. There's so many.
Was there a death or a love or a significant?
I mean, Lucy was with Brad too. Like... gets around, doesn't it?
It's a shocker.
Gosh. there's probably been once, hang on, I've got to think. Probably one of the weddings. You know, it's always good to go to a wedding in a show.
And, yeah, get dressed up.
Yeah, I think I was a bridesmaid and I'd never been a bridesmaid in real life. So I got to do it on.
Oh, that's fun.
On here. So it was, I think that, I can't remember whose wedding it was, but I was the bridesmaid. Yeah. So, I had a lot of fun. Okay, this is from Rachel. What's the best thing and the worst thing about working on Neighbours?
The best thing would be coming to work every day and doing what I love doing, you know, apart from my family and obviously my friends and things. My job is so important to me. I love acting.
Mm-hmm.
And so I love being able to come to work and you know, this show provides so many challenges in the sense that it moves quite quickly. You have to be really prepared. One day you can be making coffees in Harold's and the next day you can be crying over a long lost love or something like that. So it really keeps you on your toes. Mm-hmm. As an actor, it makes you very makes sure that you're very in touch with your intuition, which I really like. It's not too much time to kind of think about things, and I don't mean that I don't mean think in the sense of, you know, being stupid or dumb or anything like that. I just mean that you have to be in touch with your intuition, make really quick choices, back yourself, and go for it. So that would be the best thing, along with the fact that you get to work with some just fantastic people. So that would be the best thing.
What's the worst?
The worst.
Isn't there any?
The worst thing I reckon might be, I think if you get a bit run down or if you get a bit sick getting up early in the winter, that might be the worst thing. I think on this show, you know, Australia's a wonderful country, but we are a country of contrasts and we have quite hot summers and obviously not really cold winters like some countries. Mm. But sometimes the cold, you know, I haven't had to do, and I'm not planning on it either, doing like a bikini scene where I have to jump into a pool or anything like that.
Oh, you haven't had to do that.
No,
yet.
I won't be. Oh. I won't be putting my hand up for that one either. Just quietly, Mel. But I would say something like that, having to jump into water when it's cold. That would not be my list.
I've actually had to do that on the show. You know, the Lassiter's Lake. Oh. I remember once we went to location the other day, and I thought, gosh, this brings back memories. I remember Lucy when she was a teenager stripping off down to her underwear, jumping into the Lassiter's Lake, and it was freezing.
Gosh.
So
lakes had a few bodies in it, I think, over the years.